Well, we've all been moved from the airport itself. Some people on coaches. We are on foot heading to a nearby village. There is a crisis centre that has been set up there. Very little information here on the ground. We are being told now by police that it is a, this is what people on the ground are being told, that it is a terrorist attack. We heard, after we checked in, we've gone through security, the sound of two very large explosions. I was in the duty free. It's kind of, you're just going through your normal routine that you do whenever you get on a flight. I was going to get it buying chocolates for my children for Easter. And then as I was just turning after picking them up from the shelf, the explosions, and you kind of immediately, that is not a normal sound. My instincts were, this is a terrorist attack. Other people around me started sort of going towards the floor, trying to hide behind shelves. And then people from the other side seemed to be sort of coming through from where, before the security screening, coming through to the area that we were in, which was after your baggages, your hand luggages, security checks, and being to wait. But very, very frightening, very panicked passengers, because of course at this point they thought there may be more explosions, more attacks. But we have now been moved out of the airport. The airport has been evacuated. From the outside, when you look at the building, you can see blast damage at the top. Quite high up, sort of 30, 40 metres up, which have blown the glass out. There are lots and lots of soldiers surrounding the building now, obviously with automatic weapons and streams of ambulances. The wail of sirens has been fairly continuous as they go in to sort of help people who are actually who are very close to the casualties.